So guys, so today we are going to discuss the demonstration about the UI development course. So what is the use of website and at the same time, what is the use of web development things? Now we are going to discuss step by step. So before learning web designing or website development course, so first we have to know like what is meant by website and at the same time, how many type of websites we have. First we have to know. So first we have to concentrate on the website. So what is the use of website? By using website, we can promote our information online. So website is a, simply we can say it as a collection of web pages. Collection of web pages. For example, now I'm going to open some website called ELearn Infotech.com, ABCD.com, like that. We have so many websites. So now here I'm going to open one website. So just you can observe here. Here I'm going to open ELearnInfotech.com. Whenever if you are opening elearninfotech.com, we have the collection of web pages. So we have here home page, we have the about us page, and we have the courses, we have the training, like that we have so many pages. Now I'm going to click on about us, it is moved to the about us page. Whenever we are click on the courses, it is navigating to courses page. Whenever we are click on a registration, it is moved to the registration page. That means if you are observing here, we have the so many web pages. So that's why we can call it as a website is a collection of web pages. So in real-time scenario, we have two types of websites. One is static website, and second one we have here, dynamic website. Static and dynamic we have. So first, what is meant by static? Now we have to discuss. So static is nothing but it is a simply fixed content. For example, I am developing one website. That website is a static in a sense. The entire thing should be like a fixed content only. That means, so after developing this website, only developer can do the changes. Why? Because they know complete coding knowledge. Through the coding knowledge only, if you want to do any changes, we can do the changes in this website. For example, see here, now I'm going to open one website. Whether this one is a static website or dynamic website, I have to identify. So how we are going to identify in a sense, we have here extensions. For example, I'm going to click on about us. Whenever you click on about us, it is moved to the about us page. Whenever you click on courses, it is moved to the courses page. That means here we have the collection of pages. If you are observing this extension, see what is the extension we have here? We have the extension is .html. Whenever if you have the extension is .html or .htm, we can easily understand that is static website. So what is meant by static? Static in the sense, simply we can say it is a fixed content. Only developer can do the changes in that website. That means only through the coding knowledge only we are able to do the changes. We have the extension is .html or .htm. So currently all websites having the extension is .html only. Why? Because all are using HTML5 version. So if you are observing previous websites, like a 2000 before websites, like old websites, we have the extension is .htm. Maximum cases currently all are using .html only extension. That is called static. Coming to dynamic. So dynamic, we can also call it as a dynamic website. We can also call it as a web apps. So to build the web applications, so we have separate dashboard. So through the dashboard, you can do any type of changes. For example, I have one dashboard. So through this dashboard, I want to do some changes in my website. How we are going to do the changes, I will show you with a live example. Just you can observe here. Now here I'm going to open one engineering college website. So here my client requirement is they want to do some changes themselves without depending on the developer. See here, we have the latest news is calling. If you want to post some latest news, you can directly post. If you want to post some exam notifications also, directly you can post. So from where we are going to post, in the backend we have to post automatically the news and that exam notification, everything we have appear from the back end to front end. Now see here, I'm going to open admin.php. That means admin credentials here already we given to the client. Why? Because for security reason, we are going to give some username and password. Through this username and password, directly you can log in and you can do any type of changes. For example, I want to post some latest news. Directly you can post here. So for example, hi DAT, I'm going to post. Just click on post. See, the news is updated successfully. Now I'm going to check whether, so this news is reflected or not. So just you can observe here. So here whether the news is reflected or not, I'm going to check. If you are observing here, we have the hi VAT. So where we are updating this one? So in the backend, we are updating. Whenever if you are updating in the backend, automatically we are getting that news into the front end. So if you want to post any news, you can post it. If you want to do any changes also, you can do this. See here, if you want to add photos also, you can add photos. If you want to add video testimonials, you can add the video testimonials. If you want to do the exam notifications also, you can post it here. You can add events, anything. For example, I'm adding all these things. I want to edit or I want to delete also. If you want to do the edit and delete also, we have the options here. Now I want to delete some latest news. So if you want to delete that latest news, so just to scroll down, in the bottom, we have the latest news. So all our latest news only, just now only we had a, so post that hi VAT, just click on delete. Automatically the latest news is deleted. So like this, we are going to do some operations. This is called dynamic. So I'm going to revise one more time, just you can observe. What is meant by website? Website is a collection of web pages. What is meant by web page? Whenever if you are opening anything in the browser, we can call it as a web page. So if you are opening like a newspaper or if you are watching a movie, if you are opening any anything also, we can consider as a web page. Now here, if you are opening any website, we have the collection of web pages. Simply we can say it as a website. How many type of websites we have? We have two types, static and dynamic. What is meant by static? Static is nothing but it is a fixed content. That means if you want to do some changes in this website, only developer can do the changes. Why? Because they know complete coding knowledge. So through the coding only, we are going to do some changes in this website. So that is called static. How we are going to identify whether that is a static or dynamic? So it depends upon the extension. If we have the extension is .html, we can easily conclude that is static website. For example, see, I'm opening our website. If you are observing here, we have the latest news here also. Register for UI development course. For example, I'm going to update, register for web design course. So if you are maintaining like that, so first we have to know whether this is a static or dynamic. How we are going to identify? So here we have the navigation. Just click on any navigation item, we will get the extension is .html. Whenever if you are getting the .html, we can easily conclude that is static, nothing but if you have the coding knowledge, then only you are able to do the changes. That is called static. Now coming to dynamic website. So dynamic website, we can also call it as a web apps. So to build any web application, we have like a dashboard. Through the dashboard, you can do any type of changes. If you want to do the changes, first we have to log in. So for security purpose, we are going to do some credentials. Through the credentials, you can log in and you can post something, you can edit something, and you can delete and you can retrieve something. All operations you can do so with the help of dynamic websites. So this is the difference between static and dynamic. Coming to our course. So whenever if you are learning like the UI development, so first we have to know the UI designing. Like we can also call it as a front-end designing. So what is the use of front-end designing and what are the modules we are going to cover? First we have to discuss template. So first module is HTML in its advanced version, HTML5. Then we have CSS and its advanced version, CSS3. Then we have JavaScript, then we have here jQuery, then we have the Bootstrap and web hosting. So if you know all these concepts, you can try as a web designer. So what are the concepts we have and what is the use of these concepts? Now we are going to discuss step by step. What is the use of HTML? By using HTML, we can design only static web pages. Already you know what is meant by static. Static is nothing but it is a fixed content. Only developer can do the changes. Only developer can build that website. If you want to do the changes also, always we have to depend upon the developer only. So we have to depend on the developer. Why? Because they know complete coding. So through the coding only, we are going to do the changes. So by using HTML, we can design the static websites, and HTML stands for hypertext markup language. What is meant by markup language? Markup language in the sense, everything we have in the tag format. For example, if you want to display one image, we have to use some tag, like image tag. If you want to display some table, we have to use some table tag. Whatever we have in this web page, everything we have to build with the help of HTML only. See here, we have one heading. This heading also, we are going to build with the help of HTML only, like this. So if you want to display anything in the layout process, browser screen. If you want to print anything in the browser screen, simply we can do the through the HTML only, we are going to do that. Simply we can say it is a raw data. What is meant by raw data? Raw data is a sense a person without makeup. That means there is no proper look and feel. We can build here, but there is no proper look and feel. So if you want to do the proper look and feel for our website for that purpose, we can use the CSS. So what is the use of CSS? By using CSS, we can decorate the web page. Already we have the one web page. So successfully we created by using HTML language. Now I want to decorate that web page. So if you want to decorate that web page, you can use simply CSS, and CSS stands for cascading style sheet. So that name only it will describe we have to apply styles. For example, now if you are observing here, we have the red color background. So in case if you are applying like a blue color background, how it will be look like? Just I'm going to update here. So if you are observing here, we have the red color. So just I'm going to check my preview. If you are observing here, we have the blue color. So how it will be look like? Just we have to check here. So now I don't want to do the single color. I want to do the mixed colors. If you want to do these type of things, again, we have to use the CSS only. Now we can observe, we have here black color. Whenever we are moved to the right side, we have the blue color. Now I don't want to do the left to right. If you want to do the top to bottom also, you can do here. See, red and black and blue colors, three colors, we have the mixing. So not only colors, you can do the n number of shapes also. For example, now I'm going to show you another example. See, here if you are observing, we have the button. This edges should be like a normal one. If you want to do this edges should be more rounded, nothing but this edges should be rounded corner. Simply we can use the so border radius property in CSS only. So now just I'm going to apply here. Border radius, we have the property in CSS. Now just you can observe. So previously this button, it will be look like this. Now see, automatically the shape of the button is changed. If you want to change another thing, see here, now we are doing the another shape also. So if you want to do this type of things completely, we have to use the CSS only. You can observe here. So we have the round shape image. Whenever we are move the cursor, see, the image should be like a square. By default is circle. Whenever we are move the cursor, it will be like a square. These type of things we are going to build with the help of CSS. Simply we can say, so whenever if you are doing any decoration part, completely build with the help of CSS only. So in CSS, we have the types also, like we have the inline CSS, internal CSS, and external CSS. We can apply styles in three formats. So that three formats we are going to discuss step by step. So real time scenarios. Yes, Rika, tell me, Rika. Shrikant? Yeah, tell me, Shrikant.
Slowly explain that program, sir. Only.
Which program?
CSS? Program slowly, sir. Explanation slow. Yes,
okay. So, if you are observing CSS in the sense, we have to decorate. So, just we are going to do the decoration part only. So if you want to do the border, if you want to change the colors, if you want to change the font size, everything we are going to build in CSS. For example, here we have the heading. So this heading we have in the capital letters, right? Now I don't want to do in the capital letters. I want everything to be like a small letters. But first I want to change the color also. If you want to change the color, simply we can write the color property. This is in CSS. See here, we have the color is red. Now I want to display, so all letters should be lowercase. If you want to do the lowercase also, we can use here. So CSS on extra from, we have here lowercase. See, just for preview point only here I'm applying. So whenever if I refresh, again it will be old pattern only. So why? Because here I'm checking like a preview point only. So this is about the CSS we are going to use. So you have to understand one thing. So whenever if you are using CSS, simply we have to decorate that web page. So like the colors, backgrounds, font size, font families, anything you can apply. So now if you are observe here, we have the heading. This heading font size I want to apply. So by default, the font size is 21 we have. Now I'm going to increase. See, the heading size is increased here. So depends upon the client requirement, depends upon the UI, we are going to change these type of things. So just I'm going to show you here, just preview point only. So this is not applicable for live server. So just I'm going to do some changes in my end only. So it will applicable for my browser screen only. It won't apply for all browser screen. So this is about the CSS we are going to use. Then next concept is we have the JavaScript. So by using JavaScript, we can do the client-side validations. What is mean by validations? Now I will show you with example, just you can observe. So here I'm going to open another website. So here my client requirement is, so there has one quotation form. So this quotation form, we have to enter all the details are mandatory. For example, I'm not entering any details. So just click on send message. What happened here? It is showing some validation messages. So what are the validation messages we are getting here? Please enter your name. Please enter valid email. Why? Because we are not entering any data. So that's why we are getting the all validation messages here. So these type of validation messages we are going to show you with the help of JavaScript only. Now here I'm going to open another website. So here we have the phone number field. I am entering here number, it won't show anything. I'm entering characters, see it is showing input digits 0 to 9 only. Again, I'm entering number, it won't show. Again, I'm entering character, we are getting the input digit 0 to 9. That means in the coding only already we mentioned, so this phone number field allows only numbers only. Like I want only 1 to, so like a 0 to 9 numbers, please. Like whatever you are entering, that should be compulsory number only. So like this, we are trying to apply real-time scenario. This is about the thing with the help of JavaScript we can do that. So by using JavaScript, you can do the validations as well as calculations also. For example, I want to perform some addition or some subtraction, multiplication, anything. So with the help of this JavaScript only, we can do that. So in HTML and CSS, in HTML, just that is a design part of it. We are not going to do anything here. So this CSS, we are going to do the decoration only. So in the JavaScript, so this is a major role we are going to do. With the help of JavaScript, we can do the validations as well as calculations also. So this is an example for the JavaScript, like form validations. Then we have the next module called jQuery. So if you want to do any animation, simply we can go through the jQuery only. For example, I am observing some animation in my website. So that is compulsory with the help of jQuery only. So now if you observe here, we have the images. These images automatically will slide after some time gap. So how the images should be moved? So here, simply with the help of jQuery only, we are going to do any type of animations. So what is use of jQuery? By using jQuery, we can do the animations. And jQuery is an advanced library of JavaScript. It is related to JavaScript library. So completely we have like a predefined functions library in the sense we have set up inbuilt functions. Just we can use all the functions and we can implement your logics. So for example, I have the show function. That means whenever you have clicked on the button, I want to show something. So whenever you are click on hide button, I want to hide the data. By using methods, predefined methods, we have the show and we have the hide, we have the toggle, slide in, slide out, like that we have so many functions. So we are going to discuss all those functions. So step by step in our regular classes. So by using all these modules, you can easily build one website. So, but that website is device friendly or not, we have to check. What is the use of Bootstrap? By using Bootstrap, we can do the responsive layouts. What is number responsive layout? Responsive layout in the sense, so whenever you are building any website, so that website is device friendly or not, we have to check. Yeah, and then it is recorded. Okay, so responsive layout in the sense, so compulsory we are going to build any website with device friendly. Why? Because in real-time scenario, for example, I'm going to develop one website. That website maybe user has to open the desktop. or laptop or tab or mobile. So whenever they are opening our website in these type of devices, so we have to build so responsive, like device friendly. Now you can observe this website only I'm going to open in a mobile view, how it will look like. See here, we have the V offer. How many rows we have? One row. In one row, we have the three things we have. Now I'm going to open in a mobile view. If you are opening in a mobile view, see here, we are getting one by one. Like step by step, we are getting here. So at the same time, if you are observing menu also, it will automatically consign. So why it is consigned in the sense? So it is like a device-friendly website. So whenever you are developing any project in real-time scenario, we have to build device-friendly only. So this Bootstrap introduced by the Peter company in 2011. So by using this Bootstrap, we have to build device-friendly websites. So these are the devices we are going to open real-time. So we have to build one website, these type of device-friendly. If you are observing any website, compulsory, that should be device friendly only. That should be Bootstrap only. Nowadays, all are using so responsive layouts only. Without this one, we are unable to do any layout. So by using all these modules, we are going to build one website. That website, I have to launch. In case if you are not launching that website, what happened? So that program, that project it will be so in your local only. So I want to access anywhere in the sense, we have to launch that website. For that purpose, we have to buy the domain and we have to buy the hosting, nothing but server. So how we are going to buy the domain and how we are going to buy the server, all those concepts we are going to cover in the web hostings. So for that purpose, we have the service providers like the GoDaddy, BigRock, Hostinger, HostGator, LabelPost. Well, there's so many service providers are there. So just we are going to purchase from the service provider and we are going to launch our website. So by using all these modules, you can easily try as a web designer. So as a static website, if you want to design, just these modules is enough to do that part. So coming to UI development in the sense, by using all these modules along with, we have to know the one framework or library. We have to know the React.js, or we have to know the Angular.js, or we have to know the Vue.js. So what is the use of development languages? Here we are using the React.js or Angular.js or Vue.js, right? Why we are using this one? So before discussing the topic, we have to know the, so what is the use of web apps? So web apps in the sense, web applications, right? So here we have the two type of web applications. We have the single page application, we can call it as a SPAS, and we have the multi-page applications. So what is the difference between single page application and what is the difference between multi-page application? Now I will show you. See here, now I'm going to open one dashboard here. If you are opening this dashboard, now I'm going to click on anywhere. So this web page is reloading. You can observe, I'm going to click on this menu. Every time the web page is reloading, so we can simply say it as a multi-page website. What is the meaning of multi-page website? Multi-page website in the sense, whenever you are click on any navigation item, so it will be, every time it will be reloading. Reloading is a mandatory, page reloading. Page reloading is a mandatory here. So whenever your page is reloading continuously, what happened? Site performance is decreased. So to avoid that situation, what I'm trying to do is, I'm going to use the single page application. If you want to do the single page application, here what happened in the sense, without reloading the entire page, so it will change the particular view. Now I'm going to show you the Angular official website only, just you can observe here. So now what I'm trying to do is, here I'm going to, open the Angular website. Just this is the navigation we have. So just I'm going to click on this one. So whenever I click on this one, this screen, it will be changed without reloading. You can observe. See, without reloading, what happened? The screen is changed. So this is called single page application. So what is the difference between single page and multi-page application? Here, without reloading. So single page in the sense, without reloading the entire web page, particular view only will change. So that is called single page application. And so coming to multi-page application, so here every time the page is reloading, So that is the difference between single page and multi-page application. If you want to develop multi-page application, you have to use the PHP language or Python language or .NET language or Java language. Any language is comfortable to do the dynamic application that to multi-page. Now my intention is I don't want to do the multi-page application. I want to do the single page application. If you want to do the single page application, for this purpose, we can use the React.js and we can use the Angular.js. Then we have to use the Vue.js. So if you are observing, so all are related to JavaScript only. So Vue.js currently in our India, we are not using. So in Umbra, they are using. So coming to React or Angular, so this one, anything is fine. So, but what is the difference between React.js and Angular.js? Now we have to discuss. So this React.js is completely JavaScript library. Library in the sense, we have set up inbuilt things. Just you can use the all functions, whatever we have the components, that components we can use and you can implement your logic here. So this is also Angular.js, also JavaScript only, but it is a framework. It is a JS framework. What is meant by framework? Framework in the sense, set of inbuilt functionalities, set of inbuilt features we have. Just you can use the features and you can implement easily. So that is the difference. This is a library and this is a framework. So it is actually maintained by the Facebook company. Now React.js products are the WhatsApp as well as Insta also. And Angular.js is actually maintained by the Google company. And at the same time here, every 6 months compulsory, they are going to produce one new version. Currently, Angular 12 is in the market. Within 4 months, they are going to, already it is like 2 months old only. So within 4 months, they are going to introduce 13th version also. That means there is no stability. So every 6 months, they are going to introduce one new version. So here, the React.js not going to like that. So they're not going to upgrade as entire new things. They're going to do some changes. So whatever the drawbacks is there in the React.js, so that drawbacks they are going to fix. And at the same time, in that version only, they are going to introduce some new features. So that's why maximum cases in the React.js, there is no updates. So all we have the set of inbuilt library only now. Just whenever you are installing this library, we have. So if you want to upgrade also, just you have to upgrade your library only. Here what happened? You have to change your entire coding also. So that is the main difference between Angular.js and React.js. So coming to React.js. So React.js is a JavaScript library. Just we have to use the React.js for single page applications. So what is meant by single page application? Single page application in the sense, internally we have the multiple pages only, but that all multiple pages we are going to render. Render in the sense display. That all pages we are going to display through the single page. So that's why we can call it as a single page only. Here also we have internally multiple pages only. There is no single page here. We have internal multiple pages only, but all these multiple pages render through the single page only. So that means in the single page only, we are going to display all components. So that's why we can call it as a single page application. So if you know the JavaScript, for example, in case if you know the JavaScript, in the JavaScript, if you are writing the direct HTML, it is not possible. We will get some error. But in the React.js, we have the feature called JSX, nothing but JavaScript extension. So in the JSX directly, you can, that means in the JavaScript directly, you can write any HTML code that you can directly implement. So whenever if you want to do the React.js, first we have to do the prerequisites. So we have to know the complete HTML and CSS, then Bootstrap, then JavaScript. So this JavaScript is a main. So this JavaScript, so in 2015 only, they stopped updates in the JavaScript. They introduced the new features in the ECMAScript. Here, ES in the sense ECMA. So ECMAScript, so this in this ECMAScript, they introduced so many features, like how we are going to create that class, how we are going to use the map function, like the new features they introduced. Depends upon that new features only, so our React.js works. That means you have to know the ECMAScript also if you want to know the React.js. So all these ECMAScript concepts also we are going to cover in our course. Then we have the React.js side. So how we are going to create the React.js app? Now I will show you just a basic example. So first we have to go to the node version. Whenever if you want to create your React.js, first we have to check your in your system node is there or not. First we have to check. How we are going to check in the sense? So for that purpose, we have to install your Node.js software also. Just I'm going to show you. So in the direct terminal only, I have the VS code in here. So in the VS code editor only, I'm going to show you direct example. How we are going to install all these things, I'm going to teach you in our regular sessions. Now I'm going to open the terminal. In the terminal in the sense, command prompt only. In the command prompt, I'm going to check. So how we are going to check whether we have a node or not. So I'm going to check here, node-b. See here, we have the node version. And the npm, nothing but node package manager version also, we have to check. So after checking this node version and node package manager, we have to build our application. So if you want to build your application for that purpose, we have to write the some command. So we have to install first npm install hyphen z, nothing but global. We have to use here create hyphen react hyphen app. So whenever if you are entering this command, automatically your React should be installed. So after installation of the React, we have to run our application react hyphen app my app. My app is my project name. I have to create. Whenever if you are press enter, automatically this folder structure it will be automatically it will appear. So this folder structure and at the same time how we are going to create the component, what is mean by component, how many type of components, and what is the use of routing, everything we are going to discuss step by step in our regular sessions. So if you know all these concepts, so like from scratch to advanced, you can try as a UI developer. So after this course, so we are going to provide you the soft copy material as well as interview questions as well as, so I will show you some tools also in real time scenario. Just I will show you 1, 2, 3 tools just you can observe. In real time scenario, we have so many tools to build a website. So I will show you some examples here. Here I have one table here. So for example, if you want to create this table, how we are going to do that? So for this purpose, we have to use the table tag in our HTML, right? Now what I'm trying to do is, I'm not going to write any code manually. So we have to use some tools. For example, so I'm going to open one tool. In this tool, just I'm going to paste the table. If you are paste the table, just click on HTML. See here, automatically the code is generated. So if you're observing how many lines of code generated also, you can check it here. See, nearly 435 lines of code is generated. So like this, so you can observe, see here, 430 lines of code in the sense, it will take some time to write, right? So at least, so you have, it will take like a 2 to 3 hours. But here what happened, it is showing like a 2 to 3 minutes only. So now I want to do the list items, for example. So just I want some points. If you want to do these points also, just you can type it here and you can click on HTML. Automatically we will get the code here along with the styles also. So these type of things we are going to use in real-time scenario. So like this, we have so many tools to build any website or web application. So these type of tools and techniques, whatever needed in our real-time projects, everything we are going to cover. So this is about entire course.